Hello everyone, I'd like to acknowledge and thank our subscribers who commented in the last video. I really appreciate your support. If you haven't already, please hit that subscribe button as it helps us make great content for you here on this channel. What's up everyone, Gold Wolf here, and I'm in front of the camera. I'm totally gonna suck at this, but let's give it a shot. Now with YouTube supporting higher resolutions, it's just good practice knowing how to export your projects in the best quality possible. In today's video, we'll take a look at how I export high quality videos for YouTube. Assuming your project is complete and sequence settings are correct, let's jump over to our export settings. The first option I check is format. I make sure H.264 is selected. Why H.264? Because it's universal, efficient, and delivers high quality video in smaller file sizes. It's also the recommended codec supported by YouTube. Below, you'll notice a preset dropdown, select custom. This will allow us to select our own settings. Head down to basic video settings. Make sure your resolution, frame rate, and aspect ratio are all set correctly. Then check render at maximum depth. Next up is encoding settings. This is important. Make sure software encoding in performance is selected. Profile and level are interesting options. Profile is more important. The higher the profile, the better your video will look. Main option is used for standard definition television broadcast, whereas high is used for high definition television applications. So make sure you select high if you're exporting HD and above. Levels describes how much data could be used to be decoded at once to decode the video stream in real time. Yeah, I know. Super technical stuff, but in short, just make sure 5.0 is selected. Moving on to bitrate settings, you'll have the option to change the bitrate encoding. Looking into the dropdown, we have three options. We have CBR, VBR 1-pass, and VBR 2-pass. CBR stands for constant bitrate, and VBR stands for variable bitrate. To have a general understanding, we'll have to know how exporting works. When we export our project, we're asking Premiere in both CBR and VBR to determine how much data we want to keep or throw away. The higher the bitrate, the more data is retained. The lower the bitrate, the least amount of data is retained, resulting in bigger or smaller file sizes. A couple of reasons to use high bitrate is high resolution footage, lots of movement, and or particles like confetti in your footage. This is why I select VBR. My bitrate will vary depending on each shot. Using VBR 2-pass will give us even better results, but cost us more time in export. 2-pass is great because it analyzes the project, adjusting the bitrate accordingly. The first pass is all about analysis, and the second pass applies the correct compression rate. So select VBR 2-pass. Because I export 2.5K or 4K, I set my target bitrate to around 100 megabits per second and maximum bitrate to its max at 135 megabits per second. Last but not least, check the use maximum render quality. Usually audio settings are set correctly, but if you want to know mine, here they are. All right guys, with that said, you're all set to go. Excited to see how your next project exports. Hope you guys found this video helpful. If you did, please like this video, subscribe to this channel, and ring the bell to be notified when new videos drop. I appreciate all of you. Until next time we meet, go film, have fun, make killer visuals. Jason Goldwolf, signing out. Peace. Let's go.